The importance of the Soo Locks mainly is the iron ore that gets transited from the mines to the steel mills. Really, there's not an alternative means to get the iron ore to the mills that's very cost effective or efficient. It's even way cheaper than rail just because of the amount of cargo you can carry in one trip. We have about 4,000 cargo carrying vessels that come through here every year on average. They carry different commodities such as iron ore and wheat and coal and stone and all kinds of different products. We get around 70 to 75 million tons of cargo come through here on an annual basis. So it is one of the busiest in the United States. The lock is run just using the water seeking its own level. So as a boat enters the lock, the miter gates are open and they come in at the same level that they, whether they were downbound or upbound at that lake level. There's fendering systems along the pier, so they kind of, as they're coming in, they kind of slide along that pier, and there's what we have oak fenders there, and they kind of rub along there. And then at the rear of the boat, there's a guy who's sighting the boat. He's positioning that boat, so at certain marks, he'll call out, 48 or 24 or 12 or all stop, and those commands are being communicated to the captain. And also our lines people, so we know which buttons, they know which buttons to place the cable on to secure the vessel and to keep it from hitting the sill or hitting a gate or boom or something. And as they come in, once they're in and secured, then the gates close and we open some valves, and that'll either raise the boat or lower it as water seeks its own level. There's definitely a push to get a new lock here, so hopefully, and I'm sure it'll take quite a few years, but hopefully there'll be a lock, a new lock here sometime during my career.